Good morning, friends. In previous lecture, we have seen about what is functional dependency, how to find out functional dependencies for a given table. Then the next topic is types of functional dependencies. The first one is trivial functional dependency. The trivial functional dependency means if there is a functional dependency from x to y, where y is a subset of x, that functional dependency is called trivial functional dependency. Y is subset of x. For example, AB determines C. AB determines A. Here, what is the condition for trivial functional dependency? If there is a functional dependency from AB to A, where A must be a subset of AB. These type of functional dependencies are called trivial functional dependency. For us, we'll see one more functional dependency, AB to B. Here, this is also a trivial functional. If there is a functional dependency AB to B, then B is always subset of B. Here, A is subset of AB, then B is subset of AB. Here, the trivial functional dependencies are always valid functional dependencies. Why? Because here we are not determining any new things. Always AB determines A. A is also a part of the AB. AB determines B. B is also a part of the AB. Then these trivial functional dependencies are not useful for in real time. But here, these functional dependencies are always valid functional dependencies. Why? Because here myself determines my time, myself. Always, that is valid functional dependency. The example, the real time example for this trivial functional dependency is, suppose consider a student table. The student table contains SID, SName. The SID, SName always determines SID. And SName and city always determines city. And SName state always determines SName. Here always the right hand side of a functional dependency is a part of the left hand side. Those functional dependencies are called trivial functional dependencies. But here the trivial functional dependencies are always valid functional dependencies. Here no need to check for whether the given functional dependency is valid or not. Why? Because always the right hand side, the dependency is always a part of the determinant. Then only we can say that the trivial functional dependency exists between two attributes. The second one is non-trivial functional dependency. If there is a functional dependency x to y, where y is not a subset of x, then those functional dependencies are called non-trivial functional dependency. These are very non-trivial functional dependencies are very, very important. Here the non-trivial functional dependencies are opposite to trivial functional dependencies. Here, for example, if AB determines C, here always the left hand side of a functional dependency determines one new thing at right hand side. Here the right hand side is not equal to left hand side. Suppose if you are applying intersection between LHS and RHS, here it is equal to 5. These are the example for non-trivial function. Here in non-trivial functional dependency, the determinant always determines new things. Here AB determines CD. Here CD is not a subset of any AB. Then for example, ABC determines D. Here D is not a subset of ABC. Then the one point we need to remember in non-trivial functional dependency is the LHS is always not equal to RHS of a functional dependency. The real-time example for non-trivial functional dependency is, consider a student table, the SID always determines S name and SID determines phone number and SID and S name combinedly determines state of a student, but this state is not a part of the SID and S name. These are the examples for non-trivial functional dependency. The third one is fully functional dependency. Here it is also very, very important. The fully functional dependency means, if there is a functional dependency from x to y, the y, where y cannot be determined any proper subset of x. If there is a functional dependency from x to y, y cannot be determined by any proper subset of x. Here the y can be determined only by x, not a, it cannot be determined by any proper subset of X. For example, if ABC to D, here this is a fully functional dependency, when the D cannot be determined by using some A or B and C or AB to D and AC to D and BC to D, when the D is not determined by these subsets, proper subset of this ABC, here these are the proper subsets of ABC, ABC, AB, AC, BC. Whenever this is a fully functional dependency exists between these attributes, the right hand side attribute cannot be determined by any proper subset of the left hand side attribute. For example, in real time, if you consider one locker, this locker having two keys. If you want to open this locker, the two keys must be present. One key is with bank manager, one key with customer. Whenever we are having these two keys, then only we can able to open this locker. This situation, we can say that the locker is fully functionally depends on these two keys. These two keys. By using these two keys, we can able to determine this locker. If one key is missing, then we cannot able to open this locker. This is called fully functional dependency. We'll see one more real-time example for fully functional dependency. Consider a student table. Student table contains 5 attributes, that is student ID, student name, faculty ID, faculty name, grade of a student. Then student 1, a name is Shiva, the faculty ID is F1, name is some Nanda, here grade is something. Then same student details are repeated, another faculty, that is Srinath, he is also giving some A+. Then we are taking one more student, that is Krishna, faculty is F1, the name is Nanda, is also giving some A.
same student Krishna, faculty ID is 2, then Srinath is giving something.
Consider this table. Here first we need to find out the candidate key or primary key for this table. Candidate key. Here the candidate key is, here the SID values also repeated, S name values also repeated, faculty ID values also repeated, the F name values also repeated, grade values also repeated. By using single key, we cannot able to identify all attributes in a table. Then here the candidate key is a primary candidate key is a composite key. The composite key means here the by using SID and faculty ID we can able to identify all the attributes in a table. All the attributes in a table. Suppose if we consider SID, FID to grade. Here this is a fully functional dependency. Suppose if you want to calculate grade by using any subset of SID, FID, it is not possible. Why? Because by using SID we cannot calculate grade. Without faculty we cannot calculate any grade. Suppose by using FID we cannot calculate grade. Why? Because if there is no student, the faculty cannot calculate any grade for a particular student. Here the grade is always can be determined by this two attributes, that is SID and FID. This is the example for fully functional dependency.